my leg, I staggered on, spindrift, stinging my remaining eye. I finally managed to reach the station, only to find the bus replacement service had broken down. After wondering to myself if that's not should be called a rail replacement service, I wandered out onto the concourse. I noticed the giant screen seems to have been tampered with, probably a junior employee. Disgruntled commuters were being regaled with some god-awful TPM involving a tug-of-war custody battle. Stockard Channing held sway. Down in a high street, somebody careered out of boots without due care or attention. And I suggested they should avail themselves of some pedestrian etiquette, i.e. sidle out of the store gingerly, embrace the margin, like what I do. Like what Carl Pumpkin does. Fat kids with sausage rolls, poor sods conducting polls. Into perspective. I'm trying to set it against the scale of human suffering. And I think of the Mugabe government and the chairman of the Calcutta Railways. But this works for a while. Then I encounter Primark FM. Overhead a rainbow appears. Suicide watch, crew is not happy. Spotted a marsh flotilla during association, was roundly ignored. What news you? I felt sorry for him. He'd only been locked up for public nuisance offences, one of which saw him beachcombing at the estuary. He found a dead wading bird, took it home, parcelled it up, sent it off to the rubber-faced irritant Phil Cool with a note inside which said, "Is this your sunderling? Mr. McCool, is this your sunderling?" Another time saw him answering an advert in the music papers. Keyboard play required. Doors, Floyd, etc. Must be committed. Own van. No time wasters. You can guess the rest. Imagine you just wander off into the hills someday and be found months later. His carcass stripped by homeless dogs, his exposed skull a perch for the quartering crow. I folded away the letter and I placed it in my inside pocket. All of a sudden I felt pushed by the wings of something dark. The Lord have mercy on Stringy Bob.
Thank you.